Here we are, Monday morning, a beautiful morning, on the 8th day of January here in from downtown Glasgow, Kentucky, as we crank up the archives for this second week of the year 2024. And we couldn't do it without having Mr. Sam Terry sitting in the air chair over there. Sam, how are you doing this morning?
I'm well. How are you today, Henry?
I'm doing really good, really good. Just looking forward to sharing things. Of course, Sam is well known in all circles around here, particularly in historical circles. And the information you're going to hear is a great deal of the type of research work that Sam does. So are you ready to jump in here and try this out today?
Oh, certainly.
Okay, it was this day 100 years ago this day that Mr. Albert Boyd, the district manager of the Kentucky Utilities Company, has just gotten a working order through covering the expense of installing a new ice machine and additional equipment to the local ice plant, which will give Glasgow the much-needed increase in ice-making capacity. Work on the change will be finished before hot weather sets in. You think that was only 100 years ago, Sam, but here we are. One of the challenges of having a small town was having enough ice.
Yes, and it was provided by your utility company.
Well, you know, and of course, I've always known it takes a lot of electricity to make ice. I wonder, was the ice plant down there next to Gorin Park back then?
Yes.
Okay, so, wow, that was amazing to see that was the big news of the week. We're going to get enough power to make ice before it gets hot. Good news all the way around.
Start planning all the ways to use it.
That's right. The Glasgow Republican reported this day in 1934 that several local scouts placed seventh in the state contest. It was a first aid team of five members representing the local Boy Scout troop attended a contest in Louisville last Friday where they placed seventh. Their score was 94, which the winner scored a 98. The team is composed of Joe L. Goodman, Captain, Russell Daugherty, H.C. Biggers, Jr., Billy Simmons, and Edwin Page. The team was accompanied by Mr. George Carolyn, Addis Britt, George Carr Gander, H.C. Biggers, Cal Rogers, and Garland Reynolds. Those are some fine young men there in 1934, learning the ropes by being scouts.
They certainly were. Sounds like a fine first aid team.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's right. You want those kind around for sure. And some big names in there encouraging the scouts on as being their escorts. 1944, the Glasgow Times reports last week the Times told of three officer sons of Mr. and Mrs. Leo Page of Glasgow. Well, we concluded the statement with this record cannot be equaled in this section of the state. This week, Sam, we stand corrected. Of course, you and I both have been in media for a long time. You can get corrected quickly.
Yes, you can.
If you say something wrong in a news article. And in this story from 1944, they're going to tell us the rest of the story. We now tell you of a soldier family of Mrs. J.E. Burks of the Hicesville section. Mrs. Burks has three sons and a son-in-law, all commissioned in the armed forces. These officers are Lieutenant John E. Burks, Jr., Captain William Burks, and Captain James M. Burks, all her sons, and Lieutenant John J. Johnston, the son-in-law. Undoubtedly a proud mama who wanted to set the record straight in 1944.
Well, there's no doubt about that.
It's something to be proud of for sure. 1954, the Glasgow Times has this story. Many new faces at the courthouse as elected officers start their duties. County Judge Louis B. Nunn took over his official duties in Barren County along with all other newly elected county officers. Mr. Nunn becomes the first Republican ever to occupy the judge's office in Barren County. That's a strong statement. Republican ever to be a county judge, Louis B. Nunn. He succeeds Carol M. Redford, Sr., who held the office for 12 years. That's a great bit of our historical past around here.
It certainly is.
1964, a front page photo was captioned in the Glasgow Times as follows. Oldest and youngest members of the Barren County Bar Association, Paul Greer and H. Jefferson Herbert. Greer is 82 years of age. He began working in the Barren County Clerk's Office in 1903. When the soon-to-be-raised courthouse was considered new. Herbert, a member of the law firm of Wilson, Baker, and Herbert, is the group's youngest lawyer. The two were photographed during swearing-in ceremonies for Circuit Judge Kaz Walden, Commonwealth Attorney Carol Redford Sr., and Circuit Clerk George McEwen. I would like to look at that picture again, because I'm sure that was one that, our local bar association is proud of its heritage, because we've had lots of good barristers here in this community, and I'm sure the day that photo was published, the local bar association was proud.
Without a doubt, and Mr. Greer was quite a force in the legal community. Here in Glasgow and Barren County for many, many years.
Indeed.
And, of course, his home was what we know as, sometimes by his son's name, the Delvo Greer House, mm-hmm. but now the Main Street Bed and Breakfast on East Main Street.
And it's so fabulous to see that being very successful as well. Just good stuff. 1974, this day, Allen County's Dwight Blankenship scored 14 points and played a key role in the Allen County versus Glasgow game, but the team was overpowered by, 70-12?
70.
That was overpowering. That fits the definition of overpowering, Sam.
Well, either that or it's 72-70.
Well, could very well be. But nonetheless, Mr. Blankenship, that's a good Allen County name, you know. He scored 14 points in that effort. So, nonetheless, we love our basketball, and boys getting into the season for sure. This day in 1984, Mr. Jim Varney, whose character Ernest is well known to television viewers, was in Glasgow to tape a TV commercial at a local convenience store here in 1984. Nothing like a little fame and fortune to get the community fired up. Mr. Varney was
exactly.
here. Jim Varney.
Sort of a cult icon
for
a few years.
That's right. He did funny stuff, too, I'll say that. Let's look at 1994. We learned this day in the Glasgow Republican that Matt Wireman, a sophomore at Barren County High School, has been named the Hugh O'Brien Youth Foundation, or HOBIE for an acronym, ambassador. That was a nice honor for young Matt Wireman.
Very much so.
1994. 2004, the Plaza renovation is underway, being done so by Venture Contracting. That was reported in the Barren County Progress here in 2004.
Well, and you know, the Plaza has a big anniversary coming up this year.
That's right.
It'll be the anniversary of the official opening of the theater. Way back in 1934.
And there's been lots of talk about how best way to celebrate that, and it's a big accomplishment. And to the fact that we have that still in operation and making a difference in our community, I hope that the celebration is commensurate with what a big deal that is, you know. 2014, the Barren County Progress reports five local students earned spots in All-State Choir. The Glasgow students were Drew Richardson, Brianna Crowder, Drew Smith, Wesley Frazier, and Simon Applegate, the All-State Choir. You got to be good to get in the All-State Choir, and I understand these all were. That's what we have here in January, which is... history didn't take the month of January off, it doesn't appear, any of these decades over the last century.
Apparently not. A lot of good news, old news.
That's right. The good old news, and it just kind of shows who was here laying the groundwork before us. I like celebrating that, Sam, and I really appreciate all your hard work that you do for this program, and I just hope that we can get back together tomorrow and share some more good news, bring everybody back with you, okay?
I'll do it.
All right, here on the Archives on WCLU.